Hey guys, welcome back once again. In this video, I am going to show you how to handle bulk update in material table. Alright, as you can see here, I have a table with cut operation. That means you can add a row here. Okay. And you can delete a row from here by clicking on this. Okay. And if you want to update the row, yeah, you can update those row as well. Okay, so as you can see here. If you have not seen that video, please check the description below and watch that video first and continue here. So in this video, basically we are gonna to handle the bulk update. That means on click of a edit icon, I can edit all the row at a time. Okay, so let's jump to the VS Code and implement the bulk update. So here, as you can see, I am in VS Code, and this is what we have done in last video. Okay, so here I will collapse this three function. Okay, and here, in order to handle the bulk update, we need to add another one property to editable only. Okay, so here I will add comma. Okay, and I will write here on bulk update. Okay, so here on bulk update, and again this is gonna to take a callback function which is gonna to give me a parameter. Okay, so here I will call it as selected rows, because this is not gonna to be a single row, it will have the multiple row. Okay, and this is gonna to return a promise call. So here new promise, and this promise is gonna to take a callback function. Okay, and this is gonna to get two argument, so resolve and reject. Okay, and now here what we will do is, let's do console log to the selected row, whatever the parameter we are getting. Okay, so here I will do selected rows, now save it, and let's come back here. So here you can see we have this icon edit all, and on click of this you can see we can start editing any one of them. Okay, so let's do right click, go to the inspect, and go to the console here. And now let's make it as a 1, 2, 3 and hit enter. So you can see here we have a one row. Okay, and here we will have new data and old data. So in new data we can say we have Chennai 1, 2, 3, and in old data we can see we have Chennai only. Okay, so now let me refresh this one, and here again let me click on this update all, and here I have changed to 23 here something, and now save it. So here you can see I have an object of two element, and this is the 0 0 is the here key, and 1 is the key which is the indexing. Okay, so here it will be quite difficult to handle this kind of a structure. So here what we will do is, we will convert everything into an array. Okay, so in order to do that, here what we will do is, we will get all the values from the structure. So for that, let's do this. Here we will write object dot values, and here we will pass selected rows. So here I will write const and rows. Okay, and now let's print this rows here. So here I will not be getting object anymore, I will be getting a array. Okay, so let me click on all, here 3 and here 5. I have entered, and now you can see I have a array of two element. At the 0th position I have this old and new, at the first position I have old and new. Okay, so now what I can do is, I can loop through this. Okay, and here inside the old I will get the table data. So here table data will have the ID information, as you can see here. Okay. So now we need to get all the data from the our state. So here I will call const updated rows. Okay, and here I will spread this so data. Now we have all the data, and these rows I can loop through this because this is the array. So here I will say rows dot map. Okay. And here this map is gonna to give me a particular data, so I will call it as a employee. Okay, in one employee I will get the old data and new data. So here what I will do is, let's do the console log here. So console.log to the employee. Okay, and here we have seen the structure how it is. So inside one we will get this new data and old data. So I will go inside the old data. So I will say old data dot, and inside the old data here you can see we have table data. So I will write here table data dot, and inside that we have ID. As you can see here, this ID value is 0. Okay, so now let's save it and come back here. Okay, on click of this, now here, so I have updated 2, and here this one as well. So I should get the value here 0, 1, 3. These are the index value. Okay, so what I will do here is, here instead of just printing, I will write here const index. Okay, or it's better to create a variable here because this is the loop. So here let index, so let index. Okay, and here what I will do, I will replace this value. Okay, so now we have particular index, and now here what I will do is updated rows, and here what we will pass this index. Okay, so what it will do is, it will select the particular record, and now I want to replace particular record with the updated value. So here this is referring to the present. So I will write here employee dot, and this is gonna to give me the new data, which one have updated data. Okay, now save it. So basically this is the loop. So how many row I have updated, it will update all, and it will update this updated rows. Okay, so now let's come out of the loop here. Okay, so here I need to update the state. So before that, let's do the console log to the updated rows. So here console.log, and here I will write updated rows. Now save it. Let's come back here. Okay, so here I will write 12 and hit enter. So you can see I have 4 record, and if I am going here, you can see I have 12 here at the last. Previously it was 0, means 10, but now it has been updated. Okay, so here I am getting the index, and I am replacing that index with the new data. Okay, once it is done, I am doing the console log. Okay, so instead of doing console log, what we can do is, we can update our state. So here we can write set data. This is the state where we are managing the data. Okay, and now here what we can do is, we can write resolve, so it will stop the processing. So now let's come out here to the browser. Let's make this value 12, this let's make this value 80, and hit enter. So now you can see I have this 12, and here I have 80. Okay, so now we are able to update the values. So now once again let me do this. So here I have Raj, so let me make this Rajan. Okay, and here I will update his Chennai to Jaipur okay, and this one as a Chennai. Now let me hit enter. So you can see I have this Jaipur, I have this Chennai here, and here name as a Rajan. So now I am able to update the multiple record at a same time. Okay. Now we need to add the processing for the few seconds. So here what we can do is we can add a delay by using set timeout. So this same timeout is gonna to take two parameter. First parameter is a callback function. Okay, and second parameter is the time, and we will provide time as a 2 second. Okay, and this is in millisecond. So I have provided 2000. Now let's paste this one inside. Okay, now here I am missing this arrow, save it, and let's come back here. So now I want to change this Bangalore to the Chennai. So here Chennai, okay, and here this email ID I have changed, and now let's hit enter. So you can see it's processing, and you can see this one has been updated and this record also has been updated. Okay guys, so now we have handled bulk update successfully. Okay, so basically what we are doing is we are getting all the updated row as a selected row, and the structure of selected row is a object. So that's why we are trying to convert this one as a here array, okay, because object is not a proper structure. So here we are converting, and after that here we are looping through the rows, how many row has been updated. We are getting index, and we are replacing that index with the new data. Okay, once it is done, we are updating our state, okay, and resolving. So this is how we are handling the bulk update. Okay guys, so you can get download link of this code in description of this video. If you like this content, please do like, share and subscribe. See you in next video. Thanks for watching.